Today I'm going to show you how to paint some jellyfish. Now I have an 8 by 9.5 canvas here, but you could use anything. You could use paper, even a piece of cardboard that I have my paint on you could use to paint. Anything can be your canvas. I have some simple things set up here, like a old jar that I have some water in. I have 3 types of brushes. There is a large, medium, and fine tip brush, but you can use any kind of brush that you like. I have just a piece of cardboard set up in my palette, and I have a few colors out here. I have icy blue, titanium white, cobalt blue, a kind of forest green, and for a bit of flair, I have a metallic turquoise. Now you can use any, this is going to be sort of an ocean scene with some jellyfish, so you might want to go with some blues, greens. The white's going to be very important as you see as we go along. But let's get started. So basically, I'm going to take my larger brush here and I'm going to dab it on the paper towel. Sometimes you're going to want to take it and dip it into the paint like this and add water to it. Okay, that's gonna be important sometime. And sometimes you're gonna wanna use more of a dry brush, so that's where the paper towel comes into play. So I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna start with a little bit of the icy blue pearl, and we're just gonna put it across the canvas. And again, I'm gonna go into the water, get some more paint, and we're just gonna go along and make a whole background, basically, across the entire canvas or piece of paper, whatever you're using. And this is just basically going to be a base coat. Just go back and forth, back and forth. There we go. Okay, now I'm going to go back with another coat. Just another light coat. Okay, see? That's easy. Okay, so now, and this is where it really comes, it's up to you, whatever color you want your background to be. Again, this is sort of like an underwater ocean scene, so you could use greens, you could use blue, any kind of blue that you like. I mean, whatever you want, even if you want to use purple, that's fine. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with a little of this metallic blue. So I'm going to swirl my brush in it, and that's called loading your brush. So you're just going to load it up. Now I'm going to get a little more serious about coverage. So I'm going to go back and forth, and I'm going to get a little more of this, really load it up. And this paint that I'm using here is just basically your, you know, you can get it at any craft store in a little jar. It's acrylic paint. It's not expensive. It's about 99 cents to $2, depending on the colors and the brand. But it goes a long way. Okay, so now I've got my metallic blue. Now I'm going to go into the cobalt blue, and I'm going to kind of put another layer on that of this on there. And what we're doing is we're just kind of mixing the different tones, and since this is acrylic, it dries a lot faster than oil. Oil dries very slowly, but acrylic dries quite quickly. So we're working with the wet paint underneath, so we need to work a little bit quicker with this acrylic. But what we want, and you can probably see, is it's blending with the other colors underneath. So that's basically what we're going for. And I'm going to go back with a little of the icy blue, icy pearl. And I'm just creating a variety of blues to get my underwater ocean scene looking really, really nice. Okay, now think I might add a little bit of the green. Let's try some green. I don't want to add too much of this. I just want a little. I don't want it looking like a swamp. I just want a little of that to come through. Okay, now I'm going to really focus on this turquoise because I really like the turquoise. Now, if you want to work like this as well, just to get some extra blending going on, and then go across again. There we go. See how that kind of changed the whole look? Okay. Now, I think I want to add a little more of the dark. Important that the paint underneath is wet when we start to add the jellyfish. Now later, when you're done, if you want to, now on a canvas like this, if you're using a canvas like this, you'll see the sides are to go all the way around, so it's a stretched canvas. You can actually go and paint the sides if you like, or you can just leave it as is and actually just hang this right on the wall as it is without a frame. And I'll show you at the end how it looks on the back. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move to the medium brush. I'm gonna start our jellyfish. I'm gonna dry it off. And I'm gonna go into the white, get some on there. I don't want it too low. Okay, here we go. So what we do is we're going to start with the shape. So basically the jellyfish is going to look like this, okay? And you're going to come down and you're going to add. This is basically just adding the shadows using the paint underneath and giving it the depth and shape. Just like that. That's just the start, okay? Now, bring it down. I want to kind of have that shape. See how I'm going to like outline the curve there and then give it a little. There. Okay, and then I'm going to add a little middle area like that. And then all the little. Okay, so that's the beginning of our jellyfish. Okay, and I'm going to do another one over here, a small one, a little friend. And see how I'm just dragging out the color from underneath the wet paint. And now you might want to go back and add some more white.
So you see, since the paint is drying a little bit,
little jellyfish there, and we can do, if you wanted to have one sneaking up from the bottom, could do another one here. Okay. Yeah, you know what? I don't really like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I'm going to wipe him out. There we go. Sorry. Hi, little guy. Okay. So this is the basic idea for the jellyfish, but now we're gonna let it set and dry for a few minutes, okay? Now you could do them as big and small as you want and put more or whatever, but this is just a basic idea. So I'm gonna let it dry for a few minutes, and then you're gonna see we're gonna come back and do some more detail on them. But I think they're coming along nicely, and you'll see how easy it is just to get to this point. And it's got a lot of nice depth and kind of looks neat. So let's take a minute and let it dry. I just want to show some other things that you can do with it. So I'm going to show you how to add a little bit of just texture in the back or just some interest. Paper towel. And what we're going to do is we're just going to, while the paint is sort of still tacky, we can just use the paper towel and add detail like this. Now, really, if you want to do something like this, you should do it before you add the jellyfish, but I just wanted to show you this little technique. And see how it kind of makes it look a little more interesting. And really, if you do, I'm going to show you how when we start to add some more detail to the jellyfish that you can kind of just, if you decide to do this after, you could actually just wipe out the tentacles altogether and add them in again later. I'll show you. So this is just some ideas. Okay, so see? Okay. All right. Okay, so now you might say, oh no, it's ruined. But no, we're gonna go back. I'm gonna add the jellyfish again. And you could even do, if you wanted to do like swirls, you can add swirls. Okay, so now we're gonna go back and we're gonna use the kind of medium brush, small medium brush, and we're gonna take our white paint again, white paint. And you see really how very little paint we're using for this painting. Again, this is an 8 by 9.5 inch canvas. Okay, so we're gonna come up here again and do our jellyfish. There we go, get our jellyfish back in. Getting it in a little. Okay, we're gonna do him. Okay, we're gonna do our little zaggy in the middle there. Okay. Okay. See? We're back. Now, if you want to try something different, you can use a smaller brush there. I'm going to load it up. Really tiny brush. It really depends on how delicate you want the tentacles to look. Okay, so I'm going to go like this. There we go. These are a little more delicate. Yeah, see? Okay. There we go. So you see, since the paint has dried a little bit, the white is starting to come out a little bit more because there's not quite as much wetness to blend with underneath. Okay? So you can kind of bring out some. There we go. Play around with it because it's still wet enough underneath. Okay, so now as this dries a little more, if you want to add some more strong white like highlights on top, you can. So that's that